friends, you are crafting with Kim Byers at the Celebration Shop, and today we are going to find out what more we can make with the Cricut mug press. It's not mugs. So last week we made mason jars with the Cricut mug press. If you've not seen that video yet, I'm going to put that one up above for you. Today we are making skinny tumblers, and I am here to tell you that they do work. There's some little tips and tricks that I need to share with you so that they come out perfect every time. We're going to hop over to Cricut Design Space. I'm going to show you what we're doing, and then we'll go over to the craft table and we'll put it all together. And if you've not already, I would love for you to hit that subscribe button and join me for all my future videos. Okay, let's go. Okay, so here we are in Cricut Design Space, and what we're going to do is we are going to create our design on top of the mug press template for mugs. And the reason that we're going to do that is because it's going to give us a guarantee that our design is going to fall within the heat space of the Cricut mug press. So we're going to create this really fun little monogram. It's just because summer's coming and I am really excited about going to the beach. So what we're going to do though is let's go over into images and let me show you how I did this. So if you go into project type and you click on large mug press designs, it's going to bring up all the designs in Cricut Design Space. But if you scroll to the bottom, you're going to be able to find the blank templates. And so we just want to use one of these blank templates. It doesn't really matter which one. I'm going to use the straight edge and pull that in. And now that I have this, what I'm doing with it is I'm not going to cut it out or anything like that, but what I'm going to do with it is I'm just going to make sure that my design fits within it. Okay, so since I have it, I'm just going to close that. The next thing that you want to do is go into shapes and grab a square and then measure your skinny tumbler. Now mine is roughly 9.5 inches around and it's 8 inches tall. So you can unlock this square and then make a square about the size of the front facing portion of your skinny tumbler. So I'm going to close this since we've already done this. And if you look here and we click on this, you'll just see that it's 3.5 by 8. Now the 3.5 is really just kind of like what's visually looking, you know, like what you can easily see on the front of the tumbler. So I'm kind of using that as a gauge. But if you recall, I said that it was 9.5 inches all the way around. If you click on this template and just click on this interior piece here, you see it's 8.75. This is the designable area for a mug, which would be the same for your tumbler simply because there's a gap in the mug press. So this is just a really great way to make sure that you're staying within all the boundaries. So if you wanted to do some kind of fun pattern, you could. You would just, there would be that gap of like an inch, but as long as you didn't do stripes or something like that, it would be perfectly fine. So for today though, we're going to do this monogram. So what I did is I went into, and I'm going to give you the resource down below in the description, but there's a website you can go to and you can like put in your monogram information and it creates it for you, and then you just download it as a PNG. So I did that, and then I uploaded it here. I uploaded it right here as a PNG file and then changed the color. It's super easy to do, and it's really, it's free. It's totally free. So I would encourage you to do that. Or you can go into Cricut Design Space, into images, and there are monogram fonts in images. You would just go in and like search K or B or W or whatever you were looking for. Okay, so now that we have this element, which is our monogram, you can really do anything you want to. You could get a shape of any sort and then cut a circle out of it and put your monogram in it. For this, I decided I really just wanted a palm tree that would sort of curve around my monogram. So that was easy, right? I went into images and I searched palm tree, but I loved this one, and then I wanted the straight base of a palm tree like this. So I brought in two palm trees and made my palm tree. So let's go back in and I will show you what I mean by that. Okay, so you can tell these are the leaves and then that's just the base of another palm tree. When you create multiple colors with Infusible Ink, you're going to want to press it one time. So you're not going to, not like with iron-on where you're going to press the blue and then you're going to press the yellow and you're going to press the green. With Infusible Ink, you only want to press this one time. But now that I know all of this, you know, works spatially, I'm going to turn off my templates So let's turn off the background templates. Let's turn off our square. Okay, so let's go into shapes. Just gonna grab a square and I'm going to place it over the top of my design. Okay, so let's go to arrange and send it to the back. And then I'm actually going to make it smaller. I just want it to be around the design itself. I'm going to have to sacrifice a little bit of infusible ink, but I don't want to sacrifice much or no more than I have to. So that's why I'm not using this template down here. I'm just going to use this one. It's going to work great. I'm going to show you why. Okay, and so then I'm going to grab my palm tree and I'm going to turn it off for a moment, select all, and I'm going to attach. Now what that did is I'm going to be cutting the square of infusible ink and I am going to be cutting out my monogram. The reason that I did this is because I need to have that backer so that this all stays together and then I can put my elements on with it just to make sure that everything lines up correctly. Now, if you're really good at it and you wanted to, you could just do a little square or a circle around these letters and then you could, you know, hand place or worry about the palm tree separate. But I am going to sacrifice a little bit of infusible ink just to make sure that it's all on the same sheet when it goes onto my tumbler. I just want to make sure that it's going to look great. Okay, so now what I need to do is I need to turn back on my palm tree. So now I know that it's going to fit. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I have all three of my colors and I'm going to choose the joy and I'm going to go ahead and make it. And I am going to be using my mat. Okay, so now that I'm on my mat, I need to mirror image. You need to mirror image every design that you do with infusible ink or sublimation if that's what you're choosing to use it for. And so we want to go down to the next mats and we want to make sure that we mirror image those as well. Okay, so now that our joy is connected, what we want to do is to go into browse all materials and we are going to search for infusible ink. So there's our infusible ink transfer sheet and I can go ahead and mark that as a favorite. Okay, so now we're ready to go over to the craft table and put each of these on the mat to cut out with our Cricut Joy. So here we are on the craft table and these are the things that we're gonna be using today. So I have my mug press, I have my heat resistant tape, my infusible ink in a couple of different colors, I have a lint roller, I have my easy press mat. This is just going to be to set the tumbler on because it's really going to be hot when it comes out. And then I have my Cricut Joy and scissors or a paper trimmer. Now, these are the tumblers. They are so fun. These are actually glitter ones. And I got all of these from Heat Transfer Warehouse and I'm putting links to these down below. So let's move everything out of the way and get our mat ready for our very first cut. So infusible ink comes in a couple of different sizes. So this is the traditional larger infusible ink that you can make t-shirts and things like that with. And then there are smaller ones. In these larger boxes, the infusible ink actually comes with sheets of butcher paper. So if you have the larger ones, you'll have the butcher paper included. If you have the smaller boxes, you'll have to get butcher paper. You get it at Walmart or places like that. It's very inexpensive, but you might just want to have some on hand if you're going to be doing a lot of infusible ink projects. Okay, so what I did is I took out the blue. We're going to start with the monogram. And what I want to do is I want a piece of infusible ink that is roughly 4 1/4 by 4 1/4. So my Cricut Joy mat is roughly that size. So 4 1/2 by 4 1/2. We'll just cut it 4 1/2 because I want to make sure that I don't run off the sheet. So what we're going to do is we're going to put this in our paper trimmer and we're going to trim out the right size. And if you've not seen the paper trimmers, I love these because they have this little pop out side. And so you can absolutely save material by cutting it the right size the first time. And so then you have the measurement here as well. So I know that I am getting exactly 4 1/2 by 4 1/2. And then I can pop it in and cut this other side. So now what I want to do is I want to put it on my mat And the thing is with infusible ink, I like to put it down with my hands and not a scraping tool, just to make sure that I'm not, you know, damaging the ink before I use it. But make sure that your hands are oil and like lotion free, okay? So you don't wanna get that on your ink. Okay, so now that we have this on, we'll go ahead and stick that in the Cricut Joy and get our first cut. Now, one thing to note about infusible ink and sublimation is that when you're cutting it, it looks very muted, but when you apply the heat, it gets really bright. So since the Cricut Joy is Bluetooth, we'll just need to use our phone, our iPad, or our desktop to hit the go button. Okay, so there's our first cut. Now what we wanna do is we wanna take this off. You just bend your mat, not the material, and kind of let it pop off. And once we've weeded that, what we wanna do is we wanna cut out the other two colors in the same way. Okay, so lesson learned. So I've just cut out my third color. And if you notice, this looks a whole lot like the first color we cut out. Well, this is actually green. It looked blue, and so I just was thinking it was my monogram piece, and so I cut that out. But this was actually my blue. So this, just be warned, when you're using infusible ink, really pay attention to what colors are in your box and how they look when they come out, because again, heat brings out the true color. So I just recut it, no big deal, and I am confident that I'll use that monogram for something else later. Okay, so let's go ahead and take these off the mat, and then we will weed these. So with infusible ink, if you've not used it before, it's really a cracking method more than a weeding tool method. You don't want to scratch your ink, so you just kind of crack and pop at them, and then you pull away the excess. And because we really want this monogram and not the background color, we just pull that away. Now you could always keep excess pieces. It's kind of tough once you take it off the backer, but I understand for all of you that love to save material like I do. And infusible ink weeds really, really easy. Make sure you pop out those interior pieces. And then what we're gonna do is we are going to take our remaining colors. So this was our stem, and I'm leaving that intact because I could still use that for something else, right? And then we're going to place it where we think it should go, and then we'll do the same with the green from the palm. And actually, I'm almost wondering if I couldn't just cut away this, and then as long as these backers don't overlap, and then I wouldn't have to hand place that. Ooh, I'm liking that idea. So how about we give that a whirl? So I'm just gonna take a pair of scissors and I'm gonna trim this out close. And you know what? This will allow us to savor even more of that material. I dislike wasting material, but I wanted to make sure that this tumbler came out correct. And candidly, guys, every time you craft, you learn a little bit more, right? My goal is to help you craft with confidence so that you do it right the first time. Okay, so I'm just gonna place my palm tree piece. That is going to be darling. Okay, so now it's time to prep our tumbler to go into the mug press. So I have the mug press heating, and what we want to do is we definitely want to take off the lid, and remember, we are going to be putting it upside down in the mug press. So what I would suggest is taking a piece of heat tape and setting your tumbler down inside the mug press. And remember, it doesn't heat all the way up. So I'm going to kind of guess at where the heat line would stop. Actually, you know what? Let's not guess. So I'm gonna put that there. I just did a series of large mugs with the Cricut mug press. These are super cute. I'm gonna put the video up above for you. So this is how you would make patterns, teaching you how to make patterns in Cricut Design Space. So if we look at this, so yes, so this is about right. So the ink will come to about this line where I have my tape. And then this will just allow me to put my design on my tumbler and ensure that it's going on the area of the mug press that will be heated. So if you have a large Cricut mug, then that is the best way to do that. If not, flip it upside down, stick it in, and then mark it with heat tape. Okay, so what we want to always do is we're going to use our lint roller and just make sure that there is no excess anything on our tumbler. And I know what you're thinking, and I just pulled off my tape. I know what you're thinking, this is glitter. Well, this is glitter for sublimation, so it's not going to come off. So now what I need to do is I need to take another piece of tape, just real quick, put my mug back next to it, and make sure that I am marking where I want to make sure that I don't put my design. And I just did that upside down, guys. Right? Got to do it this way. Okay, so now we're marking it. So we want to make sure our design is here. Okay, so now that we have that and we've done our lint roll, the next thing we want to do is we want to take our design and remember we cut it out mirror image so that when we place it down, it will be facing us. And because we don't have a handle that we have to worry about, that's not going to be a big deal. Our primary concern is making sure that we have the bottom of the monogram straight. Okay, and so once we get one side down, take your heat tape. And we will tape down our design. And our joy kind of cut through just a little bit on that piece of the design. And so I want to tape that down as well. I would err on the side of more tape is better, right? Okay, so then we'll put this here. And guys, if you run out of heat tape, do not use scotch tape. It will ruin your project and it could ruin your mug press. Okay, so now we have all of that down. The very next thing you want to do is we want to put butcher paper all the way around this just to protect our mug press and to make sure that we don't have any bleed. So again, in the large boxes, you have butcher paper in it, and I just use my paper trimmer and cut it into thirds. And so now what we want to do is I personally am going to start my paper in the middle of my design. There goes our mug press, so that I can make sure that I'm having this piece of the design in the back area of my mug press. So I'm just going to wrap it around and then I am going to secure that with heat tape. Okay, so I have my tumbler all taped down. I have a little piece of parchment paper, or excuse me, butcher paper to put in the bottom of the mug press just to make sure that I don't scratch the top of my tumbler. And now what we want to do is we need to somehow fill in this extra space, because if you look, and then I close this, there is a gap, okay? So you can't have a gap. You need it to actually press, like mug press. So what we are going to do is we are going to use silicone. And you have to make sure that you get the right silicone, 400 degrees. It has to take 400 degrees. Not all of them do. So make sure that when you're purchasing your trivet or whatever it is that you use, that it's 400 degrees. I wanted to be able to do an even pressure all the way around, knowing that this is the center of my design right here. That's why I have the tape there. But if I had a pattern all the way around, I want to be able to do that. And I didn't want to turn. I didn't want to have to turn it multiple times to get the, you know, pressure all the way around. So I am using, ta-da, these are cookie mats. So these are silicone cookie mats, and they have made many a cookie. But you can get these on Amazon. That's where I got mine, and I'll try to find them and put a link down below if you guys are interested. But basically, these are really good cookie mats, and they will take up to 400 degrees. So what I want to do is, knowing this is the center of my design, I want to wrap. And I'm going to make sure that the center of my design is along with the center of this so that I can see where it is once I wrap it up. I am going to just roll it
And then I am going to place it in my mug press. Again, knowing that this right here, where I started, is where my design is. So it needs to go on the interior side, okay? Okay, so then we're gonna close it and see how it's so snug, and we are going to wait 6 minutes. Okay, so our mug press is done. We just open, and then I think that these are okay to touch, but this is, I don't have a heat resistant glove, and so I'm just using my little pot holder. My mom made me this pot holder. Okay, wow, yeah, I can feel the heat coming off that. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is just unwrap, and then I am going to let this cool on my easy press mat for 15 minutes, and then we'll do the big reveal. It's time for the big reveal. Everything is cool, and so we're just gonna remove our heat tape. Okay, and there's our design, so we just need to remove. Oh my goodness, guys, look how fun that turned out. I love how the palm tree is two-toned, and then the green leaves, and then this is an ombre as well with blue to green. It turned out so dang cute. Okay, so the skinny tumbler was really neat, right? I am in love with the little lid and the straw. If you have any questions about what we did here today, please leave them down in the comments. I want you to craft with confidence. I want you to enjoy your Cricut machine. And I left links down below in the description of everything that we used here today, including those sweet tumblers. All right, guys, make sure you hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you next time.